The Federal Reserve announced today that it will push some $2.3 trillion in loans to small and mid-sized businesses, as well as to cities and states. That move, together with other programs, means that the Fed's current actions exceed the entire scope of its response to the 2008 financial collapse. To take a broad look at the economic hardship Americans are feeling and the Federal Reserve's response, we are joined by Janet Yellen. She chaired the Federal Reserve Board from 2014 to 2018. She's now a distinguished fellow at the Brookings Institution. Janet Yellen, thank you very much for joining us. You've seen these stories. You've heard people's stories. We know the statistics. How does this compare to anything you've ever seen, known, or studied before?
Well, thanks for having me, Judy. This is completely unprecedented in U.S. history. You know, we got data this morning on new claims for unemployment insurance. Over the last 3 weeks, almost 17 million Americans have lost their jobs. That's more than 10% of the workforce in 3 weeks. It's a devastating blow. We've never seen anything like it. The unemployment rate looks like it's going to skyrocket to levels we haven't seen since the Great Depression. They will probably exceed, probably already do, what we had during the Great Financial Crisis. But this is a health-driven downturn in the economy. Very fortunately, we started with an economy that was healthy before this hit. The banks were in good shape. The financial system was sound. Americans, at least overall on average, had relatively low debt burdens. So this is a terrible situation. But the hope is that if we can get the pandemic under control, deal with the public health crisis, that the economy will recover much more speedily than it did from any past downturn.
Does the government have the capacity to keep people afloat who need that help for the duration of this crisis?
Well, they certainly have great capacity. And I am impressed by what both the fiscal authorities and the Fed have done so far. It's simply essential to support households and businesses through an incredibly difficult period in which they're facing losses of jobs and incomes. They're struggling to meet everyday expenses for food and rent and utilities. And this is due to no fault of their own and no problems with the job market or their businesses. So Congress has passed the CARES Act. That plus two earlier acts, we're seeing a fiscal response that is now a little bit larger than what Congress did in response to the financial crisis in 2008. Now, if this continues, Congress will have to do more, and they're talking about a package. And the Federal Reserve response has been utterly heroic. My hat is off to my successor, Chair Powell, and his colleagues for what they've announced and the creativity of what they're doing.
And in terms of what Congress has done, and I know you've been advising some of the Democrats in Congress, the people we've just heard who are struggling, who've completely lost their jobs, how confident are you that most of them are going to be helped?
Well, I think most of them will be helped. Unemployment insurance, almost the eligibility for unemployment insurance is very broad. Congress extended it to gig workers, to self-employed workers, and the federal government is going to top up what the states do by $600 a week. So that is meaningful support. You know, as you know, it's really hard in some states particularly to get through. You call on the phone, it's very hard.
Exactly.
agencies are utterly overwhelmed, and I know how frustrating it must be. Someone's been laid off. They need to buy groceries and pay the rent, and they can't get through to the unemployment office. So there is a problem, procedural problems of getting that money out, but in the coming weeks, the money should be flowing. You know, there are direct payments coming to households.
And in terms of people who own small businesses, and I mean very small businesses, who were worried, and we heard some of that in Paul Solomon's report a moment ago, between what Congress has done and what the Federal Reserve has done, are most of them going to be made whole or at least be able to survive?
Well, you know, again, there are startup problems with very big programs, but the Paycheck Protection Program that Congress passed and funded with $350 billion. Every business under 500 employees is eligible for that. And if they use the money to protect their workforce and keep them on, and in addition for utilities and rent, those loans will turn into grants. Now, they need to go to banks to apply. The banks are absolutely swamped. Probably the program is going to require further appropriations, and it's probably going to be pretty frustrating to get the money in hand, but it's there and it's coming, and it should be available to a wide range of businesses.
I know a lot of people are asking that question. We've already heard about people having difficulty getting through, but you're saying it's going to take time, but it's going to be there?
They're trying, yes. I think the funding is there, and if this period of lockdown lasts for more than a month or two, Congress will have to do more. The Fed has almost unlimited capacity with backing by Congress to lend throughout the economy. So it will be possible to mainly support households and businesses through this very difficult time. And it's really important that they do so, because we want the economy to get back on track when the public health situation allows it.
Janet Yellen, we appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Judy.